Hey folks, Kissaki here with another tutorial. Today I want to show you some boxing techniques. I will show you a complete basic set that contains all important moves like the chap, the punch and various hooks. I will show you how I perform them, how I drill them, what I think are the most important issues of the technique. If you have some serious issues or if you are in another opinion, please write it in the comments. And yeah, just let's get started. At first, I want to tell you, when you're boxing, wear some clothes or a bandage because it will protect your skin from cracking. And believe me or not, everybody tells you, oh, I do it without the bandage, I do it without clothes because it's hardening my skin. That's total bullshit. I mean, your skin is going to be as hard or as weak as it was before. Your knuckles become harder, the bone itself, but this happens by punching itself. It happens also when you're wearing clothes. And the problem is, when you have these open places, it is hindering for your training. If you punch today like crazy and your skin is totally gone, tomorrow you will not be able to train. So wear some clothes or some bandage. The bandage has also the advantage that it protects your wrist from bending over. And there's another exercise. You will see that often people doing these push-ups on the fist. You know what I mean? These. And actually, it might harden your knuckles also a bit. I'm not convinced of that. But the main advantage is that it makes your wrist harder or stronger so that it does not bend over so easily. So this exercise is not that bad and is also recommended. And push-ups are really good for boxing because it really trains the muscles you need most, and it's not so heavyweight, so you don't lose your agility or your speed, but you increase your punching power. And yeah, if you want to punch harder, push-ups is a good advice. Now let's come to the technique. We should go to our basic fighting stance. I explained that in an earlier video. We take our hands up, the lead hand in front, the rear hand is backwards, here close to the chin to protect ourselves. There are two possibilities. One, you press your hand against the chin. This is recommended when you wear gloves, because when you get hit, your hand will punch your face anyway. And with the glove, you are against it. But when you are barefisted, I prefer it to have the hand further away, so I can push against and perhaps avoid to hit myself, because the transition of the impulse is literally the same. So if I have my hand here and then hit here, it's quite painful. But if I have it here, it just hits me slightly. So I think that's better. And yeah, the elbows are in the middle, more inwards to protect yourself. So you have not a big opening here, but you cannot really avoid that. I mean, when you're punching or fighting without clothes, a lot of things are different. If you have big gloves, you can do like that and you're completely protected. But barefisted, the punch and chaps will come through. So it's necessary to block actively and to avoid getting hit. But let's come to the offensive techniques. First, the chap. The chap is the strike with the front hand, with our leading hand. As I explained in the other video, when you are right-handed, probably your right hand is the rear hand. Bruce Lee was fighting this way with the strong hand in front, but he was very sideways, so he had to do all the work with the front hand, and he barely used his back hand. I don't recommend that. I recommend to stay more centered, more with the front to your body, to your opponent, at least at close distance, and use both hands, because you can hit much faster, you know what I mean? And you can use both hands, and so if one arm gets sore, you have the full power with the other arm. And that's a good thing. I mean, most fighting styles I do it that way. So I recommend that as well. The chap. Okay, with our front hand. If you're left-handed, it's the right arm. If you're right-handed, it's probably the left arm. You have it like this. And now when we chat, we just do a small movement and extend our arm. By that, we turn our elbow outward, and the arm is like a pearl on a rope. It's going in a straight line. The hand is not, it's not dropping or whatever, or doing some crazy stuff. It's really like pushed on a rope into the front. And by that, we turn the elbow outward, and the fist rotates in about, I don't know, 45 degree angle. Then we can have, when the arm is fully extended, we can have a look over our knuckles like a sniper into the target. And you see? And we pull it back just when we have it. That's the punch. There's not really more to say. Keep in boxing when you're in close, when you're really close distance and the other is also throwing in punches, keep your chin at your chest to protect your throat. The fight will be very quickly over if you get hit at the throat. In addition, this is a good target to hit. Now the punch. The punch is a little bit more difficult because there are two possibilities. One, we put just our arm straight out and do exactly the same as we did with the chap. We rotate our elbow outward, the arm is moving on a straight line, just to the front. We are in our fighting stance, the weight is on the balls of the feet, okay, and we do this. But you see, we have not that much of range. And what we want to do is, we throw our chap, and then we want to come in with our punch, but it's just the same range. So that's not, it's not an advantage, it's not a good idea to do it like that. Not everybody recommends it, but I do. We turn our hip and pivot with our foot, like this. And therefore we increase our range. We put our arm in front and we turn our shoulder to the front and then our hip out. We do it like this, we throw our chap and then punch. You see, we have more range. It would even go through. So, I show it from this side, so, and we pivot the foot here. And it's a matter of timing that we get really the full power. Pam, 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 pam. And you really should drill that. Chap punch, chap punch, chap punch, chap punch, chap punch. And you see how I rotate. We also bring our shoulder up because it protects our side, you know. When we punch and we pull our shoulder up here, it's very tight here in between. You're better protected from the side. So that's it. And therefore you have your first combo. It's just chap punch. I also recommend to use the chap. The chap is for feeling the distance, you know. And the chap, you know where your enemy is, and you have it with a punch. You know? If you open the fight with a punch, I don't know, it's, you can do that. If it's not expected, like a pound, and yeah, then you might have won already. But usually I recommend first chap, punch, and then chap again. That's what you usually see. And the last chap is for security. So because if your punch did not hit hard enough, and your opponent is striking, your chap will distract him, might hit him when he is advancing, or just entangle with his punches or strikes and confuse them so you don't get hit. So therefore the most important combination in boxing is chap punch chap. Pam 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 pam. I really recommend also to drill the speed. And to use it moving, so you can move forward, left, right, left. So when we left, we take a step forward, then we throw right and left, and go back in our stance. Go backwards, we throw the chap, chap, punch, chap, chap, punch, chap. And the punch, when the other one is advancing, we throw the chap, and we serve a punch while we're shifting our weight back. But not really. We move our feet backwards, but the standing leg is pushing in front. So it's just like running into a wall. If you do it like this, he's coming, you know? The movement of the upper body backwards happens just after the punch. When I punch, I just move the feet. You know? And when the arm is extended, the foot is also put on the ground. So if he runs into it, you have the full force of your body weight behind the arm. And yeah, that's okay. I mean, probably you will not knock him out with this technique, but it's suitable for fighting. So you can just practice this in form of a drill. And the more often you do it, the more comfortable you will become. I often practice this with lightweight also. So I take 1 or 2 pounds, let's say 1 pound of weight in each hand, and try to be as fast as I can, you know. And I recommend to practice it with the weak side also. So when you're right-handed, with your right side in front, and when you're left-handed, with the left side in front. Not really that good. This. You see, I do not turn the punch the way I do it when I use the right side. But it's okay, I mean, it's the weak side, of course. What I also recommend highly is directly practicing the combination of kicks with the strikes. And then you go out, check again. Or so you have the time here. Because if you don't practice it, things like this happen, that you kick and punch at the same time in a weird way. But if you drill it directly, it will become easier to throw also harder kicks, even if you just start with strong and low kicks. In a way of moving, you know what I mean? It will become easier to do harder techniques. See? Front kick, chuck, chuck. Front kick. So you get the timing of your kicks to combine it with the strikes. Also, tuck, tuck. And then you can switch and come in with the kick again. Like a full round kick, or a roundhouse kick. Didn't do it now. So left, right, chuck, low kick, right, left, and right strike. You switch your position and with the full roundhouse kick. So I really recommend drilling these moves because they are very important for fighting. I mean, in most fights the moves that, or the techniques that are applied the most often are chops and punches, or strikes, you know. And therefore you should drill them really regularly and have a good speed and a good technique. Often you see people, they practice a lot of martial arts, but when it comes to fighting, even only sparring with gloves, they are like I don't know, like a bunch of bitches with their handbags hitting each other. Stay in the technique. It's the shortest way and it's the most powerful way of throwing your punches. Therefore we have technique, you know. So drill it and it will help you out of a lot of fights. Thank you for watching. Please like my video and subscribe, and always stay awake and one step ahead. Thanks.